Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytudes.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how you can apply a really easy and non-destructive monochrome effect to your images in Adobe Photoshop. So here is a photo I took recently, and here we are looking at various monochrome effects I have applied. So all of these images have the same monochrome effect applied, but with different colors. So let's take a look at the examples. So here we are with the orange example open. If we look over in the layers panel, I have this layer folder on top of the image layer below. Now watch what happens when I toggle the visibility of the folder. We can see the original photo. Pretty cool, right? Well, what's happening here, if I toggle down the layer folder on top, is that this folder contains a bunch of adjustment layers and color layers with blending modes applied. So this effect is being applied in a non-destructive way. Now check this out. The main image layer at the bottom of the layers panel is a smart object. So if I double click on this smart object, the original image will open up. Now let's say I want to apply the monochrome effect to a new image. All I have to do is open another image and drop it in. So I have another image here. I'll copy this and paste it into the smart object, close and save. And now we have the effect applied to a new image in a non-destructive way. Easy, right? So this file here is effectively a template. If I want to keep adding images and applying the effect, I can do so really easy without having to redo all the adjustment layers and effects to a new image. So in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can set up this effect to apply to your images. If you wish to take a closer look at these examples and maybe drop your own images into the smart object layers and apply the effects to your images, you can get the documents in the project folder. Download link is in the description. So with the project folder open, navigate to the project assets folder. In that folder, open the monochrome colors folder, and there you can find all the color examples. So why did I create this effect? Well, this effect is to be applied to images that are going to be used in the print brochure we are going to be creating later on in this course. If we quickly jump into the brochure design in Adobe InDesign and scroll down, we can see that these images have the monochrome effect applied to sit comfortably in the design of the architectural brochure. Now, not only do we need to apply the effect to these images, but we also need to make sure these images are also prepared ready for print. Now, if you wish to take a closer look at these examples, you can also get them in the project folder. Download link is in the description. With the project folder open, navigate to the finished examples folder. In that folder, open the ID WorkDocs folder, open assets, open PSD, and open all the PSDs. Here you can see all the images that will be used in the print brochure design we will be creating later in the course. Okay, so now I'm going to show you just how this effect was created. So let's start with the first image. So with the project folder open, navigate to the project assets folder. In that folder, open the images folder. Now in here are all the original photos, but without the effects applied. So I'll open Building 1 JPEG. Now because this image is going to be used for print, I need to make sure it qualifies. In a previous episode, I stated that four important things need to be considered. Image size, or as I like to call it, the physical size. Image resolution. Aesthetic quality. And color mode. Now if I press Command plus Alt and press I, up will pop the image size properties, and I'll make sure the values on the side are set to millimeters. So we can see here that this image is about 200 millimeters by 133 millimeters, so about 20 centimeters by 13 centimeters. So yes, this will pass the image size. This image is going to be large enough to use in our A5 brochure canvas. Next is resolution. Here we can see it's 300 dpi, so this will be good for our print. So I'll cancel this. Next is aesthetic quality. So looking at this image, it looks pretty sharp, detailed, and not too distorted. I'm happy with the quality of this image. Last comes color mode. So I'll come up to image, mode, and if it's not set to CMYK, at this point I'll make sure it's set to CMYK. We really need to set the image mode before we start applying effects and adjustment layers. If we forget and try and change it later, we will lose all the effects. So remember to do this first. Excellent. So this image is now ready for print. Now let's go ahead and apply the monochrome effect. So when we open up any JPEG image for the first time, chances are we will have this lock icon on the layer over here in the layers panel. The first thing I'm going to do is double click on the layer. I'll rename this layer to image here. I'll click OK, and now that will release the layer and the lock icon is no longer there. Next, I'll right click on the layer and convert it to smart object. This will allow us to open this up in future and placing new images. So next, I'm going to create a curves adjustment layer. So I'll come down to the bottom of the layers panel and click the adjustment layer icon, and from the menu select curves. So up in the properties panel, I'll drop down some points on the curve and tweak slightly to add some subtle contrast. Next, I'm going to add a new hue saturation adjustment layer on top of that. So back to the adjustment layer icon, and this time I'll choose hue saturation. In the properties panel, I'm going to drag the saturation all the way to the left. So now I'm going to add the last adjustment layer, a levels adjustment layer. So I'm using this one to just add some further boldness to the overall effect. If it's looking a little grey, I'll tweak the levels to make the white punch out a little. So what we have here is a nice black and white image as a base. Now I'm going to apply the colour effect. So what I'm going to do now is use the colours from the branding. So with the project folder open, I'll come back into the project assets folder, though this time click into the branding folder, and then open the branding document. Once open, I'm going to select the Synergy Purple color vector from the CMYK sample. So I'll quickly copy this, come back into Photoshop and paste, and I'll just paste it as pixels. So here I have my color sample. Now this is only here to serve as a guide for my color. So I'll press I to activate the eyedropper tool and select the color. With the color selected in the menu, I'll press G to activate the paint bucket tool and just click to fill the rest of the layer. So now I should have a full purple layer on top of my black and white base. I must make sure this layer is set at the top of the layers panel. Nice. Okay, so with the layer selected, I'll come up to blending mode in the layers panel and add a blending mode of color burn. Now with the layer still selected, I'll press Command J to duplicate the layer. With the new layer, I'll change the blending mode from color burn to luminosity. Now that's looking pretty intense there. Right now we can hardly see the image. So next I'll press Shift, select the top color layer and select the layer below and press Command G to group them into their own folder. And I'll name this folder Color Tint. Then with the layer folder selected, I'll tweak the opacity. On this occasion, I'll set the opacity to around 60%. And now we can see our image much clearer with the monochrome effect applied. Okay, so that's looking nice, but it's looking a little light. If that's the effect I want, fine, but I want to punch out those blacks a little. So here's a neat tip. So I'll come to the bottom of the layers panel. I'll select the smart object and press Command J to duplicate. With the new layer, I'll move it up all the way to the top of the layers panel. With it set on top, I'll come up to Filter, scroll down to Other and select High Pass. Up will pop the High Pass menu. So for this, I'll set the radius to 10 pixels and click OK. So using High Pass is going to apply this effect like so. Now finally, I'll add a blending mode to this layer. So to this layer, I'll set the blending mode to Overlay. And check that out. Now we have those blacks punching through. Now if we think that's a little much, we can simply come to the new high pass layer and toggle the opacity. So I'll set the opacity to 50%, and that's looking pretty cool. I'll just quickly rename the top layer to high pass. With Shift held down, I'll select the first adjustment layer, which will select all the layers, and I'll press Command G to group all the layers into a folder and name this Monochrome Effect. And if I toggle the visibility of this folder, we can turn the effect on and off. Simple. So that's our first image created. So now I'll press Command S to save. I'll navigate to my project folder. In the project folder, I'll open the assets folder and I'll save this in the PSD folder, and this will be saved as a PSD document. So that's the first image ready to be used in the brochure later in the course. So with the project folder open, I'll navigate back to the project assets folder. In that folder, open the images folder, and this time I'll open Building 2 JPEG. So this time we have a portrait image. Okay, so I want to apply the same effect to this image. Now, I could simply copy and paste this image into the smart object of the example we just created, but since this is a portrait image, I want to maintain the size. So on this occasion, I'll set up the color effect to this. So we will have a landscape version and a portrait version. So just like earlier, I'll double click on the single layer. I'll name it Image Here. I'll come up to Image Mode and make sure it's set to CMYK. Once set to CMYK, I'll right click on the layer and convert to Smart Object. Now, if I come back to the landscape image we just created, it's as easy as selecting the Monochrome Effect folder, then with the selection tool, clicking and dragging in the canvas area up into the New Image tab, and upon release, all the adjustment layers and image blending mode layers will be applied nicely. Now, since this is a different size, we will need to come and select the Color Tint folder, press Command T, and drag up the corners to cover the entire picture. The last thing we need to do here is come and remove the High Pass layer, as that's a copy of the previous image. With the old High Pass layer removed, like before, I'll select the bottom smart object, press Command J to duplicate, move it to the top, again, apply the High Pass filter in Filters, set the blending mode to Overlay, toggle the opacity, and I'll change this to 50%. Easy. I'll press Command S to save, and save this in the My Project folder, in the Assets folder, in the PSD folder, and call it Building 2. And that's the next image. Okay, so one last time, I'll navigate back to the Project folder, to the Project Assets folder, to the Images folder, and open Building 3. So here we have another portrait image. Now this time, I'm not even going to apply any filters to this. I'm going to press Command A to select all, then Command C to copy, and then Command W to close. So back in the previous portrait example, I'll come to the bottom of the Layers panel and double click on the Image Here smart object. When it opens, I'll press Command V to paste in the new image. If the image does not fit the canvas area, I'll press Command T and scale to fit. Then I'll press Command W to close and save. And now we have applied the same effect to the new image. Now at this point, it's important to mention that the two smart objects in the Layers panel are linked. When we change the image in the bottom smart object, the top smart object will also update. So when we change the bottom smart object, the top smart object will also update and apply the High Pass filter. Easy. So on this occasion, I'll press Command Shift S to save as, making sure not to overwrite the previous example. I'll navigate to the My Project folder and save it in the Assets folder with the other images, but call this one Building 3 and save. Now back in Photoshop, this has the purple effect applied, but now I want the blue effect applied. So all I need to do here is change the color tint layers. So back in the branding document, I'll select the blue color vector and copy. Back in Photoshop, I'll select the top layer and just press Command V to paste on top of everything. I'll just paste in as pixels. Once pasted in, I'll press I to activate the eyedropper tool. I'll select the color from the sample and just press backspace to delete the layer. I'll open the monochrome layer folder and open the color tint folder. I'll press G to activate the Paint Bucket tool and simply select each layer and click on each to fill the old layer color with the new color. Easy. Once I'm happy and I have done that, I'll press Command S to save. So now I have the images with the purple filter and now this new blue image with the new color filter. If I need to apply the new blue filter to any other landscape images, I'll simply open the first landscape image with the purple filter and use the same technique to apply the blue filter as I just demonstrated. So now I'm going to use this effect to apply this process to the rest of the images ready for the print brochure. As an exercise, continue to open the rest of the images and apply the color filter and save them in the My Project folder in the Assets folder. Later on, we will need these to import into the brochure design. So that's how you can apply a non-destructive, monochrome effect to your images in Adobe Photoshop. If you wish to apply other colors and effects, simply replace the color tint layers, as demonstrated, with new colors, and explore other blending modes and see what other effects can be achieved. Remember, you can also tweak the properties of the adjustment layers to refine the effect. So now we have drawn out our design on paper, we have created the pattern for our design in Illustrator, and we have just prepared the images in Adobe Photoshop. Now it's time to start in Adobe InDesign and build our design for print. In the next video, we are going to begin by creating a business card. See you in the next video.